Hi friends, welcome back to YouTube. Now Tushar Prajapati. After finishing the 5 or 6 practical of the group policy, we are going to learn a practical of the trust relationship between two different domains. First, we have already one DC is TUS.com. This is our server 2016 with TUS.com, and in a member server we have also created a DC is TRP.com, and you can see that in our status we have added alternate DNS as 10.001, which is the main DNS of server 2016 main DC of IP address of DC 10.001. Sorry, this is the IP address of TUS.com, which is added in TRP.com, and similarly in server DC in network setting you can find that status 10.002 is alternate DNS, which is added in which is a DNS of TRP.com, which is added in alternate in TUS.com. So you can contact the connectivity between like this ping 10.002. So means you can get the system to connectivity. You can connect with TRP.com IP computer system to member server IP address. Similarly, from member server go to CMD ping 10.002, you can connect it by system 1, which is a TUS.com. But right now these are two different domains, so let's start. Our prime goal is to make a DC. Is that you can say in TRP.com one user is Bhavik T Patel, it should be logged in on TUS.com, and similarly and users similarly in active directory users in computers there are two users, which is also in Tushar Prajapati, it should be login on TRP.com. So this user of TUS.com should be login on DC of TRP.com, and Bhavik Patel should login on TUS.com. This is the aim of this Active Directory trust relationships. So first you should go to Active Directory domain trust, then right click on properties, click on trust, click on, this is the by default child domain that we have already created, but we have not deleted the trust because it was a by default trust relationship when we create the child domain, but unfortunately we have not deleted. Click on new trust, click on next, net bios name. So the name of this is TUS, then we have shown TRP.com. Which kind of trust you want to select is external trust or forest trust. An external trust is a non-traded trust between domain and another domain outside the forest, and non-traded trust is bounded by and forest as a transistor between two forests for our users. So we have to select the foresters. Then go to select. So these are the one way user in domain can be authenticated in the specified domain or forest. User in the specified domain for the. So we are selecting the two way trust. Similarly, this domain only, otherwise the both domain and specified. So we have working on two different domains. So we select the both this domain, the trust relationship in the both local and specified domain. We must have to create the privileges. Now add password. Select the scope of authentication. This is forest wide authentication or selection wise. So we are selecting the forest wide authentication. Similarly, also out for this previous one is for outgoing trust authentication level to level forest. This outgoing authentication specified forest. So similarly, skip the option forest wide. Next. Then you should confirm the trust outside on the north. Confirm the outgoing. So yes, confirm the outgoing trust. Do you want to confirm the incoming trust? So yes, confirm the incoming trust. Now the trust relationship has been created between. So this is the forest trust. Now check the similar situation on the first refresh the server. Now go to the directory. You can see that trust relationship has been created. Now, as you know, we have to log in this is a normal, you cannot log in with the in a diamond controller as a normal user. So we have to create the allow login local policy for domain, like first tools, go to group policy management. For allow login policy, we should go to default domain controller. Edit it. So go to computer configuration policies. This we need to check where is the Windows settings. Security settings. you can see the allow log on local. In the local policy, you can note down this part: Windows settings, security settings, local policy, and security settings. And local policy and user and second one, okay? Local, local. Because we should log in onto Bavi. So first we need to change the location. Okay? Because this is ts.com and log in. We should go for ts.com. Then we should go for Bavi. Bhavik T. Patel. Bhavik 1988. Similarly, first we need to update the, this is a group policy, so we need to update the group policy with the update slash. Similarly, on the member server, go to tools, group policy, same process that we have to do on the trp.com. This is for two server members. Domains trp.com default domain controller policy. It takes some edit. Go to computer policies. In a computer configuration, Windows settings, this is the first time we are opening this, so it takes some time. So, security settings. User rights assignment. Hello, global local. Go to add a group, browse. Here we search and location. Choose the TUS.com. Then check user data. this is our DC of TUS.com. So we should log in on by using Azure. That other user, first we need to TRP, then slash, then Bhavik 198. This is the first time we are logging with so we change password. So this time by the using this method you can log in as a Bhavik on a Bhavik T Patel is now logging with our domain controller TUS.com by the authentication of TRP.com with trust relationship. Similarly, go to member TRP.com, then sign out. Just login, not for authentication. The only authentication of only for login. If you know, then you have to use local administrator password to open the server manager. But you can do login by using trust domain clause. Local administrator password of that DC it should be known. Otherwise, you cannot do. The practical of the trust relationship between two different domains and login with authentication of allow local policy. So this can be not happen on the local normal local user, like as you should give the follow our local policy because you should log in on the DC. If you want to log in on client, then that is the practical of different. It is using my stub job. So we will do it later once we will learn the DNS structure like a deep forest lookup job, reverse lookup job, anything. This is the next practical. So if you like this video, then subscribe my YouTube channel Tushar Prajapati and press the bell icon of with all notification, and thanks for the coffee. Bye.